Returning to our top story this morning, and it's been revealed by Seven Spotlight that Lisa Wilkinson wargamed with Brittany Higgins on how to recruit prominent politicians and media figures to help the former Liberal staffer's case ahead of her explosive interview. Recordings of the pair, along with Brittany's partner David Shiraz and Wilkinson's producer Angus Llewellyn, revealed the group brainstormed which MPs would ask questions during question time about the
friendly MPs, you know, that could fire questions in question time.
We could fire.
Oh, certainly Albo.
Yeah.
Tanya Plibersek.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And Environment Minister Tanya Plibersek joins me now, along with Nationals MP Barnaby Joyce. Good morning to both of you. Tanya, you have just heard the audio there of Lisa Wilkinson speaking. Were you approached by her or her producer to raise Ms. Higgins' alleged assault in question time?
Well, I didn't watch the interview last night. I just saw the footage that you ran there. I don't think it's any surprise that people know that I've been an advocate for victims of sexual assault, domestic violence, child sexual assault for the last 30 years. And it's, you know, I guess the most disappointing thing about this is we live in a country where, in general, the odds are stacked against victims of sexual assault. Only about 13% report to police, and of that 13%, the report to police, only a fraction ever get the guilty conviction. So it's no surprise that they would have been working out how to get questions raised about an alleged very serious crime that occurred in Parliament House when we couldn't get straight answers out of the Prime Minister or any of the senior ministers that had questions to answer about how this incident had been responded to. Mm.
So with respect, could you answer the question, were you approached by Lisa Wilkinson or her producer to raise Brittany Higgins' alleged assault in question time, Tanya?
No, not by then, but I was in contact with Brittany to check on her welfare. I was very worried about her. I was very worried about her indeed.
So were you approached by Brittany Higgins to raise questions about her alleged assault in question time?
I checked on her. She didn't have to approach me. I checked on her. I wanted to make sure that she was going okay. And I was very worried about a woman young enough to be my daughter who made a very serious allegation about a very serious crime in Parliament House, when we couldn't get a straight answer from the Prime Minister, from any of the senior ministers involved, about any action that had been taken to follow up on what was an extraordinary breach of safety in a building that's supposed to be the highest security building in the land.
Exactly, and that was a very important issue. But during that conversation, did Brittany Higgins approach you to fire questions in question time in the Australian Parliament?
Nobody tells me what to ask in question time.
Did she ask you?
I reached out to check on her. She didn't reach out to me.
And in that conversation, did she ask you to ask questions in Parliament about this topic?
I don't recall anything like that. She's a very upset and fragile young woman that I was checking on. That's my involvement here.
Okay.
And I actually, it is absolutely no surprise that anybody would think that I would follow up on an instance like this. For 30 years, I have been campaigning for better investigation and better treatment of victims of domestic violence and sexual assault and child sexual assault. It's been a constant part of my political activism long before anybody ever heard of Brittany Higgins. I've been doing this for decades now, and it'd be no surprise that I would be interested to make sure that justice was served in a situation like this.
And we absolutely need that in this country. I don't think there's any argument there.
Barnaby. Well, it's not happening currently, that's for sure.
Exactly.
There are too many victims of sexual assault who don't report to the police, and those ones who do report to the police very rarely get a guilty conviction.
Exactly, and that is a travesty. Barnaby, you reached out to Brittany Higgins after after this story broke, you sent a message to her in which you described then Prime Minister Scott Morrison as a liar and a hypocrite. We remember that. It was widely reported. What do you make of Ms Higgins' allegation of recruiting MPs to raise her alleged assault in Parliament?
I was approached by a number of women who had similar issues, and we got legislation changed so they could get greater access to the documentation to support their case. I was very disappointed when Brittany actually disclosed an email that wasn't even to her, it was to another person in the media. But, you know, I'm not so, you know, if Tanya had to ask questions, that doesn't really worry me, to be honest. I was just listening to what Tanya said then. That's, I don't think that's a big issue. I think what is a much bigger issue is Katie Gallagher being the finance minister. If she was in correspondence with Brittany beforehand, I want to see all those emails, any of that correspondence, because Katie Gallagher was a finance minister that was responsible for the alleged $3 million payout. Now, that is the part that concerns me, and we need to get to the bottom of that. That's an awful lot of money, and we've just got to make sure that this is completely and utterly transparent, because it's not our money, it's the taxpayers' money. Let's find out about it.
Exactly, and I think that will be followed through in the coming days. Tanya, will you watch this episode of Spotlight last night, given that you won't?
No, I don't want to watch it. No, I don't want to platform Bruce Lehman, sorry.
You're not interested in what went on behind the scenes, the allegations that your name is mentioned, footage that hadn't been seen before of the two of them walking into Parliament House?
No, I don't need to see that.
Just to get a fuller picture?
No. I'm not deciding the case here. This has gone through the courts, and, you know, the result is as the result is, and, you know, it makes no difference whether I watch it or not.
OK. OK, we thank you both for joining us this morning. We'll see you next week.
Thank you.